Hello friends, in the last video the question was, will the landing gears get retracted on ground if the landing gear lever is moved to retract position without installing the landing gear safety pins?
Many of you had answered in the comment box. When there is no hydraulic pressure, landing gears does not retract. Hydraulic pressure is required for retraction of landing gears. With hydraulic systems pressurized, there is no system to prevent landing gear retraction when the lever is moved to up position and there is no ground lock pins installed. Due to aircraft weight, the actuator may not have the capacity to move the landing gears up on ground. But it is not written anywhere, so never try to test it. Always install ground safety pins on landing gears on ground before any maintenance. In aircraft major maintenance like C-checks, during the replacement of landing gear extend retract actuator or its pressure hoses, aircraft maintenance manual asks to do landing gear retraction check as normal procedure or an alternate procedure in which, with all ground safety pins installed, pressurize hydraulic system A, then move the landing gear lever to up position after pulling the trigger, you can see the actuator trying to retract the landing gear. This is main landing gear actuator bay. This is the actuator and its hydraulic lines and its hanger support. It is just outboard of main landing gear on the bottom surface of wing. This is landing gear lever. You can see a wheel in front of the lever. This is the trigger, lock override trigger. It is between two guards. You have to pull it and then lift the lever on ground. The trigger is in between two guards. Why? Because even by mistake, the lever should not be operated. Always be careful with this lever without pins, and when hydraulic is on, never operate this. Few think that transfer valve inhibit the retraction of landing gears on ground through PSEU with the on-ground signal from sensors on landing gears. It is not so. Transfer valve only switches between the normal hydraulic system and alternate hydraulic system in two conditions. Condition 1. In air. When there is no hydraulic system A pressure, transfer valve sends hydraulic system B pressure for alternate retraction of landing gears only. Condition 2. On ground. When nose wheel steering switch is in alternate position, transfer valve sends hydraulic system B pressure to nose wheel steering system. This is transfer valve. It is just in front of PTU. It has two connectors. It is controlled by proximity switch electronic unit. It can also be tested using proximity switch electronic unit. This is proximity switch electronic unit. It is in forward equipment bay. It operates transfer valve in two conditions. First condition is in air when there is no hydraulic system A pressure and the landing gears has to be retracted. Second condition is on ground when the nose wheel steering switch is in alternate position. There are two landing gear compressed sensors on each landing gear. It has two parts. The lower part is the target. It is attached to the upper torsion link. The upper part is the sensor. It is attached to the shock strut.
These are the junction boxes. These sensors signal the PSEU that the aircraft is on ground or in air. This is nose wheel steering switch. It is a guarded switch. It has two positions, alternate and normal. When this switch is moved to alternate position, the PSEU sends signal to transfer valve on ground to send hydraulic system B pressure to steering system. This is reaction link and this is lock strut. It is between reaction link and the side strut. These are downlock springs and between is the downlock actuator. This is downlock sensor. The reaction link transfers most of the side loads from the main landing gear to the upper end of the shock strut. This is inner door. You can see the tie rod connecting it to side strut. This is center door connecting to the shock strut and this is outer door. The inner door is hinged to the center door using two hinges and a tie rod to the side strut. This tie rod can be adjusted. The inner door is connected here by the hinge using bolt. This is an aft hinge and there is a bonding jumper also. This is the forward hinge and the bolt. This is a center door. At the bottom it is connected using two fittings and at the top it is fitted with two tie rods, forward and aft. This tie rod can be adjusted. There are serrations here to adjust the door. The outer door is hinged to the wing. This is a hinge. There are two hinges, forward and aft. The outer door is connected using a tie rod to the landing gear. The forward hinge of the outer door has an extension and that is connected to a tie rod. There is a tie rod. This tie rod goes inboard towards the landing gear. Here we can see it. See, the tie rod is coming and connecting to the landing gear extension. See, it is connected over there. This tie rod can be adjusted to adjust the position of the door. We will have a question now. What is the difference between left and right main landing gears? Answer the question in the comment box. We will discuss about it in next video.